Good morning. No, no, not just good morning. Hello, my friends. Hello. Welcome to the Spaniard Show. Welcome to AMXbooks 618, studying the book Unplugged 6. Whew. You know what? I just got done doing a workout that's going to fit really, really, really well into today's lesson. I did the old, I'll tell you here in a minute what I did. Oh, boy. All right, let's rock and roll here. Let's get ready for this. Let me get set up. Let's let you get set up, and then we're going to rock and roll with today's episode of AMX Books. Welcome, Dread. Quick reminder, you can watch this on Facebook, facebook.com/CharlieSpaniard, where Yuns are all at. And then I'll be uploading all these videos to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/CharlieSpaniard. Keeping it simple. Let's get ready to rock and roll. Guess it's time to get up or something. Let's get rocking and rolling. All right, let's do this. One, are you ready? Facebook, YouTube, podcast, whomever else is watching. One, two, three. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the Spaniard Show. Welcome to AMX Books 618, studying the book Unplugged. Now, I'm a little bit hoarse, and that's because I just did a workout that fits extremely, extremely well into today's lesson. There's nothing better than when you read a book, okay? You read a book, you learn this thing, and then you experience that thing, and then it dawns on you, oh my gosh, that's exactly what I read. So gonna put a couple things together. A couple months ago, I went to the Spartan World Championships out in Lake Tahoe. I met a friend of mine, John Witzing, and we had a sit-down interview, and it was incredible. And he told me about all these crazy, stinking challenges, the whiteboard project that he and his buddies were doing. They got in a box, a shipping container out in Lake Tahoe, and ran on a treadmill for 24 straight hours in the dark, right? Sequestered from everything, sight, sound, everything. They were in the pitch black. He had this other smaller challenge that I wanted to dive into, and I did dive into a couple weeks ago. It was turn out the lights, get in a pitch black room, and do as many burpees as you can. They said at 31 minutes and 33 seconds. When I did it, I accidentally set my watch at 30 minutes. I forgot. Anyway, so I'm sticking to 30 minutes. So I go to the gym this morning. I've been dreading this workout. It's something that's tough. It's uncomfortable. That's not a staged cough either. It's just burning my lungs. It's burning my quads. It's burning my pecs. It's burning my arms. It's burning everything. 30 straight minutes in the pitch black. Burpees, ready, go. And the whole idea is just to become one with that experience and just go. The first time I did it, I did 299 burpees. This morning I went there, I did 319 burpees. Now, I want to dive into that a little bit. 319 burpees, that's 20 more burpees than the first time. I set no limits. Last time when I went and did this workout, I set this limit and said, okay, when I get to 300, then I'm going to go balls to the wall. Today I said, screw it, I'm going balls to the wall. So it hit me harder, it hit me deeper, it was a deeper pain, it forced me to fight through it more. Here's the thing, I lost count twice during that 319 burpees because I allowed my mind to wander. Lesson on mindfulness, lesson on being right here, right now. Now, am I 1,000,000% certain that I got 319? 98% certain that I got 319. But then that brought me to the next point. Who cares how many I got? Who cares? Did I walk out of that experience thinking I pushed myself to the utmost? My quads were burning to the point I couldn't have done one more. My lungs were burning. I couldn't have done one more. Did I walk out of there? Yeah. So that's what truly matters. And that's an underlying theme of this book. Now, that's not to say I'm never going to keep track of reps and it doesn't matter all the time, but this morning, the gist was, hey, I lost count. I cannot be life and death sure that I got 319. So what truly matters here? That I push myself above as much as possible. Segue that into a podcast I listened to yesterday on the Human Optimization Hour with my friend Kyle Kingsbury. He interviewed a guy named Jason Kalipa. Jason Kalipa is a former CrossFit champion, 2008, has an incredible story. Listen to that episode on the Total Human Optimization Hour with Kyle Kingsbury, the On It podcast. Jason Kalipa is talking about family, he's talking about business, successful family, successful business. He's encountered adversity. But here's the thing, in CrossFit, I'm not very familiar with CrossFit, probably as the average person, but there's this exercise idea, AMRAP, as many reps as possible. You're going against the clock. All right, so 30 minutes on the clock, ready, go. Similar to what I did this morning, to be honest. So Jason Kalipa was talking about this AMRAP mentality, and he said it dawned on me, wait a minute. if I'm getting as much as I can out of this workout, right, this burpee workout or whatever he was doing, if I have the Spaniard and go into the gym and I'm getting as many burpees as possible in 30 minutes, okay, he realized, wait a minute, why can't I apply this mindset to every other area of my life? As many reps as possible, get as much as possible, get as much bang for the buck as possible. So he said he segments his day. When he's with his kids, he gets as many reps as possible, meaning he is all in with his kids. When he's with his wife, as many reps as possible, all in with his wife. Business, as many reps as possible, all in with his business. And he cuts these lines, these black and white lines between start, stop on this, start, stop on that. So I really, really connected with that idea of AMRAP because it gets into the idea of this book being that we're split, right? We're there's so much to do that we don't do anything and our minds are going in 1,000 directions. I actually made it a point of it last night when I was watching television to not allow myself to grab my phone. I was watching the Meat Eater show on Netflix with Steve Rinella. And I didn't allow myself to get my phone. So listen to these podcasts, reading these interviews, they are going to affect the actions that you take. And I wanted to throw at you a little bit of a shift of gears here. But have you ever wondered, I talked about this before, and you hear so many people talk about it, you know, what's the best? What's the way to go? Do I do this diet? Do I do that diet? Do I do this training? Do I do that training? I really have come to appreciate a holistic approach to life. Right? That's fitness, that's nutrition, that's mind, strong body, that's my relationships, just a holistic, I want to look good, I want to feel good, I want to play with my kids, I want to have a great relationship with my wife. So there's so much anxiety and confusion as to which program to use that there's this idea of the 80-20 principle. They talk about it in the book Unplugged. I've heard it's called, I believe it's the Pareto principle. You can apply it in different ways, but here's the deal. Quote, by following a basic 80-20 approach to activity and nutrition, that scoop of ice cream you enjoy once in a while is not going to kill you or prevent you from reaching your goals. So what does that mean? That means that you're making the good choice over the not so good choice 80% of the time. That's it. 80% of the time, make the right choice. 20% of the time, don't make the right choice. However that, remember, success is negotiable. However that makes sense to you, if it's 70-30, if it's even 50-50. Look, if you're 80% right now making the wrong choices and 80% right choices is too much of a stretch for you, cut it down to like, you know, just go bit by bit by bit where you're working closer and closer and closer to that ideal of 80-20. And then the last thing is a quick reminder. It's the Wednesday before Thanksgiving, November 21st, 2018. We're about ready to have some vacation time, most of us here. Get outside. This is a quick reminder. This is a PSA brought to you by the book Unplugged and the Spaniard Show. Quote, this is a crazy stat. Quote, a study by the Environmental Protection Agency found that typical adult spends 93% of their time indoors while the average child is outside for less than 30 minutes a day. This is, quote, creating biological and psychological problems that didn't exist before the Industrial Revolution. Isn't this incredible? 93% of their time indoors for grown-ups and kids play outside 30 minutes less a day. Let this be a reminder, folks. Get outside. Get your kids outside. Go eat some turkey. Have some fun. Get up and move in this Thanksgiving vacation. Remember, get as many reps as possible. Hey, when you're eating that turkey, I'm gonna get as much turkey as I possibly can in that sitting. This has been AMX Book 618. Please continue to check out the things we have to offer. CharlieSpaniard.com. Connect on social media at Charlie Spaniard. Coming out with a special episode tomorrow. Episode number, I believe it's 206. This one's straight from the heart. We have a dread episode coming straight from the heart for you loyal fans, followers, listeners, friends, etc. You're going to enjoy it. Have a happy Thanksgiving. But you know what? I'll be back tomorrow morning. I'll be back tomorrow morning with AMX Book 619. See you, folks. Hello, Doug Templeton. It's a new name. Sometimes it feels good just to talk. Just to talk and get it out there. Oh, man. Gotta pack up my mic. Gotta bring my mic home. Look at this, folks. This is tomorrow's lesson plan already made. And then, look, I'm out of notebook paper. Out of journal paper. That means I gotta go to the store today. Get some journal paper. Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow for AMXbooks 619. See you. Happy Thanksgiving.